Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Ed and Art Mashofsky, Mashofsky Enterprises, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland.
BYU won the toss of the coin and elected to defer until the second half, so the Ducks will get the football to start the game, and this is what will be an offensive show, to say the least. Now you see a beautiful setting, the Wasatch Mountains, and BYU's stadium is nestled in the foothills of that beautiful setting. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. First of all, for the Ducks offensively, Reitzik, Dykes, Husko, Hall, Kunzman, Collinsworth up front, and then the other skilled position players, Musgrave, Lavelle, Berry, Obi, and Joe Merton. For BYU defensively, Orr, Adams, Fusi up front, and then the linebacking core. Robinson leads the team in sacks. He's number 9. Hanson, Davis, Johnson, a big outside backer there at about 6'4", 245 pounds. They made some changes in their defensive secondary this week. Bergeson moving from corner to safety, and Crutchfield, number 24, who doubles as a kickoff returner, moves to the corner position.
Come on a rollout, first play, looking to pass. They have it covered, and Musgrave scrambles forward for 7 yards.
So, second down and 3.
Back to throw again. Musgrave tries to throw it out on a swing pass to Berry, but it's deflected, and it falls incomplete.
And third down and 3. First offensive possession of the game.
Musgrave back, slips. Couldn't get his footing there, and threw incomplete, and we have to punt the ball away in our first series.
So here comes BYU back. Detmer. That's Franson, number 87.
He had a big day. He caught 10 passes for 188 yards and 3 touchdowns. He killed us.
And later in the drive, second and 7. A little delayed screen. Whittingham, the fullback, gets about 10, and then on second down and 6 from the Oregon 23, the defense comes up with a big play. Detmer to throw.
Chris Oldham in tight coverage, man-to-man, breaks in front of the BYU receiver and intercepts. You see we're in a blitz here. Kearns is blitzing. He gets picked up by the guard and just kind of taken over to the BYU bench. But good job by Chris Oldham, who had a real tough day, probably his toughest day as a Duck.
So the Ducks get the football back and now get a drive that will culminate in a touchdown. And this is kind of the way offensively things went most of the day for the Ducks. Great effort here by Latin Berry.
That's on short yardage, and we pick up the first down. Great effort by Latin Berry.
Mixing it up. A little dump pass out to Latin.
Get a good block by Hargain out in front of him there, and Latin picks up about a 16-yard gain, another first down. You can see Musgrave just going to come out, and Berry chips the guy, and then Kunzman's out to block him, and Musgrave just kind of jumps and flips it out there.
And gain of 21.
Davis down there to make the tackle.
The ball now is at the BYU 44. This is 3rd and 4, another big third down play, Joe Merton.
That's a hot read off the blitz, inside backer blitzed. Musgrave and Merton saw it, and Musgrave threw the pass for the first down.
This is a 2nd and 10 play.
Good job hitting Bosley in the seam of their zone there. Picks up another first down.
So the ball now to BYU 17. Rattenberry, good hard running, gets 6.
That's a sucker play. We false keyed their linebacker, and he followed the guard, and we just gave it to Latin in where the guard left. Good hard run there by Latin around our left side.
Gain of 8. 1st and goal at the BYU 3-yard line. Take it in right away. Derek Lavelle for the touchdown.
Off tackle, you can see good block by Latin Berry on number 9 at the point of attack, and Lavelle takes it in for the touchdown.
So the Ducks score first, go 4. Go the distance, and you see 4:54 left to go in the first quarter. Now BYU comes right back, and he has ability to scramble, but that time David Cusano got to him.
You can see Detmer coming to the left of the picture here. Brantley forces him to hold up. Williams misses him, but Cassano gets him.
Loss of 9. Second down and at 19.
Didn't seem to make much difference with their offense. Incomplete here. Now it's third down and 19. Nice coverage by Horton, and we're called for face mask. And now they get second down over again. And they hit a little check pass to Bellini coming out of the backfield. He's covered man-to-man by Roy Derry, and they get the first down.
Gain of 18 on the play. Now the ball at the Oregon 46.
Hit the tight end, who's their leading receiver, out in the flat, and Mark Kearns comes in late, out of bounds, and we're tacked on 15-yard personal foul. It's a good call.
So now, on the first down from the 19, Whittingham breaks loose for the touchdown.
They get the touchdown, plus we're offsides, which will be assessed on the ensuing kickoff.
So the game is tied 7-7 with a little more than 2 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Come right back. Joe Reitzik had a great day. 7 receptions on the afternoon. Was open all afternoon, it seemed.
Runs good routes. There's a personal foul on BYU, although he got the worst of it, really. He hit Latin on a pass that was clearly overthrown and already dead. And they call a personal foul on BYU.
So the ball now in BYU territory, the 44.
Come with a reverse to Obi. Good speed here. Excellent run. Picks up, I believe, 18 yards on the play. We're going to run the toss sweep to Lavelle, and he'll hand it back to Obi. Coming around from Todd Geddeson, number 72, out leading. And Obi cuts it up inside of Merton and Musgrave's block and takes it outside and couldn't quite get him down.
So that was one of the last plays in the first quarter, this being the last one we will see. Lattenberry, good speed again, gets away from Davis, and a gain of 16.
Big third down conversion here. Do a good job checking Latin out of the backfield, goes through the line of scrimmage. Musgrave hits him, and he picks up a key first down on. We did a good job, for the most part, again, on third down in this game.
Into the second quarter we go, and the first series of the second quarter, one of the key series in the ball game is the Ducks are driving, trying to take the lead, and they are deep in BYU territory. They have a second and goal and get down to the 1 yard line on this play.
No question, this was one of the key points in the game. We put Latin into the line on the left side, and he's just short, maybe a foot and a half short of the goal line there, and we go on the right side with him. And
fourth and goal.
We get stuffed at the line of scrimmage and probably lose a foot or two there.
Now Bill said after the game that the play was supposed to go to the other side.
It was supposed to go to the left side, but you know, that's one of those things.
All right, so BYU held and moved the ball, but the Ducks eventually held, and now here they come back again offensively. Why was this particular pattern so successful all day?
Well, they play fairly soft with the corners in zone, and play action fake. Musgrave does a good job looking the coverage off, and Reitzig runs great patterns. Great catch there by Terry Obi. He came down right on the football, knocked the wind out of him. You can see drop back pass here. Good corner out by Terry Obi. Leaf, just a great picture, great shot of it. And you can see he comes right down with that ball on his chest and lower and upper abdomen, knocks the wind out of him.
So he had to come out of the ball game briefly, but eventually went back in, had a big day. It was the same pattern again. Joe Reitzik trying to get that right foot inbound, but clearly did not, although he thought he did.
He's made so many of those kind of catches, you know, you just kind of believe he had his foot down, but you could see that it was just out.
It was a good call. So Greg McCallum to come in to attempt a 40-yard field goal, nails it down the heart, and with that field goal, tie the Oregon school record for field goals in one season at 17, the old record set by Kirk Dennis. So the Ducks with the lead, 10-7.
Detmer's got a lot of time, but this time Matt LeBounty comes in and gets the sack.
We'll take another look at it.
A good play-action fake here, fooled our people up front a little bit. They're doing a good job protecting here. And you can see LeBounty come in, number 90, get clipped in the back as he does it, but gets the sack.
That was his 11th tackle for a loss this year. That's as many as Scott Kozak, who led the team a year ago, had.
In the whole season. That's just bad coverage there. We just let the guy run up the seam unmolested. They throw right down the seam, and Franzen catches a big pass for a first down. Another dump off. They run. We're in man-to-man coverage, and Darrell Reed got actually picked and blocked by their tight end. Picked off illegally, I might add, but it's one of those things that happens. Draw play here. Fumbles forward. Good job by Derek Horton. Thought he had a chance to take this one all the way, and I think he should have probably stayed to the left rather than cutting back to the field. You can see the run, the draw play inside here to Winningham. And Kearns puts his hand right on the ball and knocks it out, and it pops up in the air. And right there, Derek should have broke to the outside behind Chris Oldham and allowed him to block, but he cut it back inside. But a big turnover and a big play.
You are allowed to advance a fumbled football in the air. If it hits the ground, the defense cannot advance it. So that's why he was able to run forward with it. Musgrave scrambles, throws it downfield. Tony Hargain, he's done this a lot this year, goes up in the air to make that standing catch. Gain of 43.
Same pattern. We were going to make him think we were going to throw the corner pattern and come back to the post, which we did, but we didn't protect very well, and Musgrave had to scramble and kind of throw off of his heels. Nice catch by Tony Hargain.
Unfortunately, though, the drive stalled, and on an attempted 21-yard field goal, the hold apparently wasn't good.
It's a good snap. Musgrave did not get the ball down correctly. Here we fumble the thing around, and BYU gets it. They call us for an illegal forward pass there. And Bosley had the ball, and when he got hit, it popped out forward, and they called it a forward pass.
What was illegal about it?
I don't know. It's behind the line
that's
of scrimmage.
What I'm
saying, behind the line of scrimmage, you can do it any time, but that's apparently they have different rules in the WAC.
So here comes BYU right back. This is a wild end of the second quarter, as you will see, as both teams get the scoring opportunities, and the Ducks end up coming out with a halftime lead. Detmer to throw again. It was a very accurate throw. Bellini makes a nice catch as Rory Derry was right there on the coverage.
Great pass. I thought maybe that had been out of bounds, but it was clearly in bounds. He had both feet in bounds and a good call by the official. Now they come back. Roy Derry gets cut. Batista just can't quite catch him, and they go around us for the touch.
So the score gives BYU the lead with the extra point, 14-10, 3:13 to play second quarter. But some strange things yet to happen in this period. Musgrave to Lavelle. He makes about 7 yards and a roughing the passer penalty. Gives the Ducks 15 more yards. And so the ball now out at the Oregon 42. Musgrave now will find Joe Merton.
A big tight end from Eagle Point. Had a very good game. Caught 3 balls, blocked well.
He's played very well the last 3 or 4 games.
Yes, he's back healthy now and having a real good year in the last half of the season. Good job by Joe. You can see him make the catch. He's got to put that ball away a little bit better. He fumbles one later that we fortunately recover.
Ball now to BYU 34. Time running out, second quarter. BYU leading 14-10.
Same pattern that Reitzig has caught about 3 or 4 of during this contest. Play action away from him. Post corner, you can see him in their picture there just going out, making a move on the corner, comes back, and Musgrave throws it in there just before he goes out of bounds.
The drive again stalled, so on 4th and 9, McCallum now breaks the school record for field goals in a season with this 28-yarder, and the Ducks trailing by 1, 2:03 to play first half. Now BYU with the lead, trying to get more points. Detmer trying to go to the tight end, Smith, but Eric Castle, outstanding interception, his second of the season.
Great, great concentration by Eric on this play. Trying to go deep, BYU, they throw from anywhere, anytime, and this time they paid the price. As Castle comes over, you can see him bouncing the ball, juggling it, and catching it on his back with great concentration.
I cannot remember a game where there were so many acrobatic catches on both sides.
Good job by Reitzig again on the same route he just caught on the previous drive. Back to throw again. Musgrave now throwing over the middle to Russell Lawson and Jeff Thomason down there to recover the fumble. And I'm not sure that was a completed pass. Now that, you know.
Well, if you're not sure about this one, wait till you see one later in the game.
I mean, this is questionable whether the pass is even complete. You can see he just gets it. Yeah, I guess it is. He took one step and the ball, the BYU player put his helmet right on the ball and the ball comes out. And Jeff Thomason alertly, he could have picked that up and run it in, but fortunately we recovered it on the five, or on the three.
It's even better than the five. And it didn't take long. Lavelle over the top, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And now the Ducks have taken the lead thanks to the turnover.
Good job here, blocking at the point of attack. Joel Merton, the tight end, getting a good block.
Derek has always had a nose for the end zone. He knows how to get the ball into the end zone. Now, you went for two because that would have made it 21-14, but it's no good. So at halftime, it's 19-14. But we have one final play to show you as BYU still trying to move downfield. But Peter Brantley says, no, let's end the half, go to the locker room with the sack.
Good job by Brantley just on the hard upfield rush. And they're looking to go deep the last play of the half, and we get the sack.
Into the third quarter we go as the Ducks leading 19-14 at halftime. BYU will get the football to start the third quarter of play. And right off the bat, the defense comes in and does the job, especially here on the third and less than one.
Real good play there by Cassano and Farwell. Third and very short yardage. See Cassano come off and see Farwell in there. Just a real good job holding him short of the first down.
You see it right there. As Bellini tried to get it, and so the offense comes back. And at this point, looks like it's about to take over control of the football game. Leading by five and trying to mount a drive to go up by more. Lattenberry gets 16 on third down. A couple of key third down conversions in this drive.
Really did a good job. There's another nice pass to Terry Obey, and there goes the water. We're going to watch the replay here of the spilled water on the sideline. Good job by Bosley coming back in and picking up the blitz. Musgrave under pressure, throws. Nice catch by Obey just before he steps out of bounds and into the cups of water.
Somebody had really gone out of their way to line those things up just perfectly, too, and that all for naught. Second down and 12. Joe Reitzik again for a first down, a gain of 17. So the ball now at the BYU 38-yard line.
Good blocking on the toss sweep out of the two tight end set, and Lattenberry gains 13 yards.
Normally, we would show you replays of 13-yard gains, but in this game, they're minimal gains.
Good job blocking at the point of attack there, and an 11-yard gain by Lattenberry. Excellent job by the offensive line.
So down near the goal line on third and six, get it all. Tipped pass by one of the linebackers, I believe, into the hands of Terry Obey.
Got a little fortunate here, I think. I'm not sure exactly whether Bill was throwing this to Merton or to Obey, but it's a touchdown, so we'll take it.
As Norm Dixon tipped the ball, number two. And you get the ball right back as the defense holds. After BYU had botched up a kickoff return, they were pinned in their own territory at about the two.
Big hole at the line of scrimmage again by the offensive line. Good job by Rick Hunt blocking down. Excellent job by Kurt Dykes picking up Davis, their fine linebacker. And Lavelle is into the secondary, clear to the safety, and runs to the corner before being knocked out of bounds.
The ball now at the BYU 17. Ducks leading at 26-14, third quarter.
Bill on the rollout sees nobody in contained position and gets up and out of bounds for the first down.
Gain of 11. First and goal at the six.
Good job by Bosley here. Almost gets it into the end zone.
And on second and goal from the one, Derek Lavelle over his third touchdown of the afternoon as he continues to add to his all-time scoring lead.
It's a good job going up and over. Good job by Rick Hunt there, giving a little extra effort to get into Davis to allow Lavelle to jump over the pile.
33-14, the Ducks seemingly in control. And in this kickoff return,
you can see it's only kicked down to the 6-yard line. We get out flanked, and away he goes. And Chris Oldham makes the tackle after a 60-yard return.
And so a stadium of 63,000 that had sounded like a tomb now got excited in a hurry.
And a great pass and catch here. Nice catch as he laid out to catch that ball in man-to-man coverage against Darrell Reed.
Second and goal.
Pressured here. Great throw. Beats Chris Oldham. Franzen, who had a great game. Nice catch. Good execution by BYU.
And Detmer, just incredibly accurate. He just does not throw many bad passes.
Get the ball back here and throw a pass to Franzen again on the curl in front of Oldham. Oldham makes a tackle.
What could you try to do in situations like this? I know you were trying to use four linemen, three linemen. Here you get the sack eventually, change up your coverages. You tried just about everything.
We did. We tried it all. It just didn't work very well. You can see how much time he has to throw here. We have good coverage down the field on this one. He can't find anybody open. And we finally get to him as Williams misses the sack and Cassano and Brantley get it.
Huge play right here, third and 24.
They roll completely away, we're in a zone coverage. No way this should ever be open. Perfectly thrown pass right in between Oldham and Horton for the first down, and that's just a real big play.
Into the fourth quarter we go. The Ducks have the lead, 33 to 21, but BYU is driving, trying to get some more points here and close the deficit. You see Detmer on the rollout. Throwback screen to Whittingham, but smelled out by Rory Derry.
Good play, man-to-man coverage. Stayed with kind of like our flow screen that we've thrown to Lattenberry. You can see the fullback 33 slipping out to the top of your screen there. And he comes in, but excellent job by Rory Derry being there to make the play for the loss.
And a big play because it forces BYU to go for a field goal. It is good, but still the Ducks lead by nine, so the Cougars need two scores to take the lead. After an interception thrown by Bill Musgrave, the Cougars come back, but the Duck defense also comes back. Franzen fumbles, Derry on the recovery.
Great job by Eric Castle here. Watch him as he comes to make this play from his safety position. We're playing a three-man rush here and a eight-man drop zone, and you can see Castle break on the ball and rip the right arm down on it, knocking the ball out. Great play by Eric Castle and an alert recovery by Rory Derry.
But unfortunately, the offense unable to move the football, so BYU gets it back with 12 minutes to play in the game. You see the good pressure. Detmer just had to throw it away. So on a third and 15, this is one of those ones you were talking about.
Sure, we're in man-to-man coverage with good coverage down the field, but he scrambles out and picks up the first down before Andre Williams can catch him from behind.
Gain of 19. Second and 10 now on this play from the 43. A little dump to Bellini again.
Missed a tackle. Fordell Reed trips him up.
And the next play we see is third and 6. Franzen stays in bounds and goes in for the score.
Oldham went for the interception, missed, and that's what happens when you miss. It takes it right in for the touchdown.
So you see, still 10 and a half minutes to play, and the Ducks holding on to a two-point lead. And this will be a key series again, and a controversial play will result in this drive.
Nice job by Hargain there. Good effort there by Joe Merton breaking out, but fumbles the ball, but Hargain alertly is there to recover it. You can see on the replay here again, Joe Merton is going to come across the middle here. Musgrave has good protection, hits Merton again in man-to-man coverage. He breaks out of the tackle, but fumbles the ball right there, and Hargain fortunately recovers it for us.
And this next play may be as key a play as there is in the game. Is this a catch and a fumble? And who is it recovered by?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. It's recovered by both of them, and the tie goes to the receiver. Now, I don't know whether it should have been ruled incomplete or not. You can see on the replay here, he never really hits the ground with the ball, so I think it's probably an incomplete pass. But you can see he's up in the air. The ball is coming out right there just as he hits the ground, bounces at his feet. He's got it in his feet there, and he reaches it, pulls it into him. He's got his hands on it. BYU's got his hands on it. The official who calls this cannot even see the football. He comes up from behind and will signal BYU's ball without even looking. It's an incredible call. The official coming right there, it makes no call.
You're exactly right. Now, that personal foul did not take place on that play. It took place on another play.
And that was a critical penalty on a third down play when BYU threw incomplete. They called Peter Brantley for clotheslining a receiver, and he hit him in the chest. Legally, it was not a penalty.
Unfortunately, we didn't have a shot that would show the situation, so we couldn't show it to you.
Great catch and throw there by BYU in man-to-man coverage. They beat us on the post.
That was Nyberg that made the catch, and then on first and goal, it's Mortensen, Eric Mortensen, for the touchdown. And now BYU has the lead 38-33. And all the momentum is on your side. And credit and a tip of the hat to the offense on this drive, Coach. This was one heck of a drive.
Great job by Joe Reitzig.
So first down out at the 38. Go to the run.
Sweep to Lattenberry. He picks up about eight.
The Ducks pick up the first down, so now it's first and 10 at the 48. What a catch here. Russell Lawson.
And now he comes back and throws to Terry Obey, who makes a juggling catch for the touchdown.
You go for two.
We need two here, obviously, and we run Obey across in motion. Now they come back and get Franzen in the corner of the end zone on Chris Oldham for the touchdown.
So the Cougars, 90 yards, nine plays. They consume only 2 minutes. There's still a minute to play, and one's thinking, even though you don't have any timeouts left, the way this game is going, there's still a chance. First down, incompletion.
Well, we thought we had a chance. We needed no timeouts left, but now Musgrave hesitates, gets sacked from behind, and fumbles the ball, and that's the game.
So the final score, BYU winning it 45-41. Let's take a look at some of the team stats. You can see whopping numbers, to say the least. As we mentioned, school record for the Ducks in most offense in a game, and the rest of the statistics pretty evident there.
Well, what we felt is if we won the last five, there would be no question. You know, 8-3, we'd be in great shape. Nobody could deny us. At 7-4, I think we have a chance, but how good that chance is, I don't know. But it's our only chance. It's the only thing we have left, so we've got to go after it.
All right, so next week it'll be the Ducks against the UCLA Bruins from the Rose Bowl, live telecast at the 3:30 p.m. Saturday from the Coliseum, not the Coliseum, but the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. I'll get it right yet. They used to play in the Coliseum. All right, for the coach, I'm Todd McKim. Thanks for joining us this week, and we will see you next week with highlights of the Ducks against the UCLA Bruins.
Oregon Football 89 is made possible by Harold Taylor, Taylor Electric Supply, Portland. Immer and Oswald, Volvo and Subaru, Gladstone. Ed and Art Mashofsky, Mashofsky Enterprises, Portland. And by the Oregon Club of Portland. Subaru, Gladstone.